that battle, and the faceoff was outside.
Ferentz in his own zone for Boston. Waits and waits before throwing the pass ahead. It's pretty good. To Krejci. Took his pass. Shoot, scores! Krejci took the pass. And Horton skated for the net. 1-0 Boston.
He got banged up in the first period. He missed a little bit of time, and then he came back. And thanks that he did, because he drives to the net. And number one line has been so good for Boston over the last two games. They've got 5 goals and 5 assists. Lucic and Krejci were all the scoring they had in game six. And Horton drives to the net. Nobody picks him up. And Krejci follows him in and lays a puck right onto his stick. All he has to do is direct it into the back of the net. 1-0 Boston.
The way these two teams have played, it feels like 10-0. Gets Lauer with 1:03 remaining. 1-0 Boston. And they hang on. They got a chance here on the far side. The shot is stopped by Rolison. He wants to keep it going. He wants to get out of the net. The Tampa Bay Lightning are down to 50 seconds, that is. Long shot, gets off the stick and in. The net is empty. The play is called offside. 44 seconds remaining in the third period of a 7th game in this Stanley Cup season. I cannot believe the way this has unfolded. This crowd is standing with a 1-goal lead.
And your top 5 guys are gassed. They're absolutely gassed with 44 seconds to go. They're trying to stall as much as they can on Tampa's side, because LeCavalier, Stamkos, St-Louis, they're all been on there for almost a good minute of hard work, and they haven't been able to get in the zone. I don't know how much they got left here.
Well, Rolison has to come back in now with his faceoff near center. He's edging out. I think he'll probably stay there about 15 feet in front of his net. He backs all the way into the blue ice, waiting for the referee to drop the puck at center. See who wins the faceoff. See what happens. 44 seconds remaining. If ever the Tampa Bay Lightning have to be calm, they must be calm right now and try to control the faceoff. And number one item for them is to get the puck in deep and then take off after it.
This is the new thing coaches do. They question the clock. The loudness in the building, seconds that tick off, it bought them a good 30, 40 seconds of rest. Good job by Guy Boucher.
And here we are, center ice, faceoff. Dumped to the Boston line. Seidenberg got the center and snapped it in. 37 seconds remaining. Stamkos, if you could ever skate with the puck now, here's the time. He comes to the line. He goes to center. He fires it in. Stopped by Chara. Net empty down there, remember. It's going down near the net. And the Lightning get back. But only 20 seconds left in their season. Maybe. Long shoot in. It's stopped at the line. They're offside. That might do it. Chara has the puck. Seidenberg has the puck. Listen to the crowd. It's deafening. Empty net. It's going to be a 1-0 win. Boston Bruins have a date with the Vancouver Canucks this coming Wednesday in Vancouver for the first game of the best of 7 for the Stanley Cup. And these are the two coaches. They have plenty of respect for each other, you know darn well. The Boston Bruins getting 1 goal at 12:27 of the third period from Horton, Krejci, and Ferentz assisted. And that's all she wrote.
What a game 7. You couldn't have scripted this any better. Both these teams played their absolute hearts out. And you hate to see somebody going home here, but the Boston Bruins had the majority of the quality chances in this game. If it wasn't for Dwayne Wilson, the way he played, it could have been much different. But at the end of the day, these fans have been waiting since 1990, and they're going to get another chance to go to the Stanley Cup Finals.
Rolison, 38 shots by Boston. Stopped them all but one. Tampa Bay had 7 shots in the third period. Couldn't get one by Thomas. He had 24 saves for a shutout in a most important game for the Boston Bruins. The Prince of Wales Trophy will be presented to the Bruins tonight at TD Garden in Boston. Look at Stamkos. He has a broken nose, they tell me. The puck hit him, hit the covering of the mask. It gave way, and he got his nose broken from it, but came back out rather quickly when they fitted him, as you saw, with a bigger, heavier mask.
There comes Marty St. Louis, and I know when he hits Tim Thomas, this is going to be quite an emotional meeting between these two.
Let's go down to Scott Oak.
Bob, thanks very much. With Milan Lucic, Milan, 2 7-game victories by the Boston Bruins in the postseason. What won this one for you?
Just like the last one, I guess all we needed was Nathan Horton. He's been our hero in against Montreal, and he was our hero here tonight. We played hard start to finish, and I really feel like we deserve this one.
0-0 in the third with both goaltenders playing extremely well. Were thoughts of overtime creeping into your mind on the bench?
Not at all. I mean, we just wanted to keep applying the pressure like we were. We knew eventually one was going to get by him, and I think today we had more shots than the last two games combined, so it was great to get that one in the third.
You're a Vancouver boy, and you played a wonderful regular season game at Rogers Arena this year. It was your first chance to play in front of family and friends, but now you're going back to play for the Stanley Cup. How do you envision it?
It's a dream come true. All my friends and family are happy, and I'm sure I've converted a lot of them into Bruins fans, that's for sure.
Thanks a lot, Milan.
You.
Appreciate your time. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Horton had 17 points in this series, none bigger than the point he got tonight. His 8th goal of the playoffs from Krejci and Ferentz. Krejci took off and fed it over to him, and he beat Dwayne Rolison 12-27, as Gary pointed out. What a heartbreaker for Tampa Bay and Dwayne Rolison. Probably his best game for a while.
Can you talk about two bigger goals in the history of the Boston Bruins and sometime now? Nathan Horton, Game 7 Montreal overtime, Game 7 Tampa Bay, the only goal in the game. He gets them into the Stanley Cup. And in 1990, I was part of that Bruin team that moved on to play Edmonton, and we did touch the Wales Conference Trophy. And we'll see if they decide to touch it or leave it alone.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Prince of Wales Trophy. Ladies and gentlemen, NHL Deputy Commissioner Bill Daly will now present the Prince of Wales Trophy to Bruins captain Zdeno Chara.
Well, he's not going to touch it, I don't believe. he called everybody over to circle the trophy, and that's just what they're doing.
They're going to surround it, but they're not going to touch it. And it's a bit of a superstition that teams have. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. You look at Cam Neely and Don Sweeney looking down. Those guys are part of the 90 team. And congratulations to the Boston Bruins.